Wow.
That's so great.
You can bring him up close, but you can raise her head back up.
Friends think I'm moody, but I think I'm just fine. I could be pissed, but I act like I'm not. I really remember when I say I forgot. No matter how hard I try to run away from love at the end of the night, I need somebody who loves me naked. Someone who never asks for love, but knows how to take it. Are you that somebody who sees a wall and breaks it?
I know he
no, I ain't still sitting at this house for you.
Like, bro, just let me be great in these streets. Could you not let me be great? Like,
okay, you guys, so it's 1:50 in the morning and Carter just broke my water, y'all. I don't know how to feel right now. I don't know if I'm nervous or I'm happy. But I was just complaining earlier today that, you know what I'm saying, I'm tired of being pregnant because he is too heavy. So, something happened earlier, which will be for another video. So, you know what I'm saying, it's some good news. And right now, Darius went back in the house to grab something. I don't know what he went to grab, but we're on our way to the hospital because Carter disrespectfully broke my water. It was just like first it was like a little gush, and now it's like gushing a lot. So I'm not having any contraction, I'm just having heel pain. Yeah, I'm so happy. I was so tired of being pregnant. I was so miserable. But I'll come back to y'all when I'm in the hospital.
Oh, my water did break.
I'm still at 3 centimeters though, so. And that hurts. I don't know why they're still mad. Like, he really is a hater.
I will show y'all. Let me see if y'all can see this. The baby heartbeat is it. At 126 or 120, yeah, 126.
There's need to get my Vaseline. He got me going all sad with these lips.
Get Vaseline inside that red bag.
Yeah. You said what?
Inside the red bag.
No, the green. I mean the baby bag. Yeah. Sorry.
But
no, like, I am so happy because I'm gonna have this baby, because like, I was just all day, I just been like, what, why he don't like me? It ain't at the top.
So tell him about what just happened.
Okay, so y'all want to see that baby? He's trying to stick an IV in my hand, but y'all know the I'm just calling her a hoe because it's the nicest person. This hoe really just is for my vein that wasn't even there. It's like, it ain't no vein right there. She's trying to be funny. Like,
show
us again. Show us the vein. What is it? Where a vein is? It ain't nothing but a blood clot right there now. I mean, a bruise.
Ain't no
James.
She just fishing.
Now she tell me, hold on right quick. No, you hold on before you get pushed. And that's for her buggy, but it ain't funny because it really hurt for real.
I'm sorry, my baby.
Like, and then she thought she finna come in. She thought she finna come in here and stick my hair. I know she lying. I know she
gonna get back when she get pushed up.
I know she lied. She's doing too much for me. They already playing games with me. Like, we can go into another hospital because I'm not gonna do this with them. Like, this is the same thing that happened to you last time when I came here.
The
thing
will always be best,
though. I'm not finna be nobody to take them. You see?
No. Alright, so go ahead and tell your fans you're gonna be right back.
Yeah, I'm gonna be right back, because I ain't got time. Greg, why are you sitting over there looking at me like that? So, y'all, it took three people to come in here and do this. Like, three different times. Like, sis. What I do to deserve this? Like, for real, what I do to deserve this? Because I ain't got time, for real. I ain't got time. I'm ready to go home already.
Me too. That's all we can agree on.
I'm trying to figure out what he do. You right.
So I mean,
Jess about to pass out because he seen them do this one.
And then they won't give me no socks, so now my feet hurting.
I done asked for some socks 3 times.
I'm finna hit him.
Jordan might got him, and she might come through with the come through. I still feel like my water is still leaking. But this medicine got me feeling like I have to throw up. What they gave me in my IV, they give me antibiotics for root booster. I don't know what antibiotic they gave me, but I'm allergic to penicillin, so they couldn't give me that. Yes, you ain't that tired for real.
My eyes.
I'm gonna have to come back with y'all later because I really feel like I'm finna throw up. Like, so much pressure. Okay. I'm tired.
You already sick of this, huh?
Mm-mm. I really can't go back home.
You can't go back home. The water's broken.
They ain't even doing nothing.
Yep, you said you're gonna be chilling at 7 o'clock.
They're not even running no medicine through me. So what's the point of me being here?
Cause they said you're gonna be chilling at 7 o'clock first before they do anything.
I got that medicine taste in my mouth.
Look so tired. Don't worry.
I want some food. So, 6:22 in the morning. Davis is knocked out. We've been here since like 2 something. They're supposed to be checking me at 7. I've been having consistent contractions. I'm not dilated some more. That's what they was waiting on. But this is the one. She brought me some cranberry juice and some ice. I'm just waiting. My hair getting knotted up in the back because I've been having a little bit.
Hang on. Eva, lay your head back. Will that help?
Yeah.
Okay, yep. And push up on the bed and lift your bottom up.
Lift your hips up.
Good job.
Lift up one more time. I'm going to slide this underneath you, Trent. There we go.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Good job. Thank you.
Are you cutting up? Baby, what time is it?
It is 4:03.
It's 4:03. June 4th. I had Carter at 12:51. We didn't necessarily vlog the labor part because y'all was acting crazy. Like, I did it natural, so of course it hurt. Cause I can't play with no epidural. I just don't want them side effects for the rest of my life. But yeah, labor was going easy until I dilated to about, what, 6?
7.
7.
At 6, you started acting foolish now.
Yeah. Six. So about 6, I started acting a fool because it was hurting, y'all. And then I was already hungry on top of that. So that ain't do nothing but make it worse. I know I look a little rough a little bit, but here's Carter. I'm so handsome. He looked just like his daddy boy. But Darius was doing good the entire labor part. Like, he was massaging me and everything, y'all. I am so grateful and thankful. But my mom was there, and my brother and my son, of course. When Carter came out, King just like, oh no. Since you trying to play me. That's what kind of attitude he had. You trying to play me. I knew that you had something in your stomach, but I ain't know what that. But hopefully, I'm not going to say hopefully. They're going to get along. King just going to have to get used to him or whatever. I got Carter in here at the end of the bed because I just want to see him sleep by himself.
No, I always do that to him. Okay, just leave him.
But for the most part, they did tell me to not push, but I pushed anyways. So I actually delivered Carter in like...
You took him off.
In like 10 seconds.
Rosa wanted to bed in my
house. Oh. Okay, y'all. So, me and Darius is eating food or whatever. And today's been a long day. Y'all shit my pretty little baby. He look just like Darius. I knew it. But Darius over here. Eating. I ain't record all day because, like, people will come in and out, and I ain't feel like asking nobody, like, do you mind if you're on camera? I didn't record. In fact, I was sleeping. Even though I didn't sleep that long. But, let's come to give y'all the update. Carter was 7 pounds, 5 ounces, and 19 and a half inches long. And I delivered him at 12. 51. And y'all, yes, I did cut up. I did act the food because I went natural. Like I did last time. I don't care how hard life get. I'm not getting epidural. I don't care how bad it hurt. Because that ain't eat. And that's lit. You know what I'm saying? But y'all don't pick on me because I know I look real rough. But I just had a baby. So y'all spare me. We watching movies and eating right now, so I'll holler back at y'all. Okay, y'all, so it's kind of late in the day. I think it's like 5. Is it 5 o'clock yet? That's it.
You
serious? I was 2:50 in the afternoon. We basically been chilling all day. I got up, took a shower, detangled my hair. Just, you know what I'm saying? Just doing this shit and shit. But no, for real, I feel good. Like, I have to give y'all the tea on my delivery, because the way I just delivered this baby, y'all would have thought I was somebody else. So, the doctor had checked me, and she said I was, what, at 9?
No, she said she was at 7 centimeters.
Oh, yeah.
6, 7, and jumped to 9.5.
So, 30 minutes before I pushed... Okay, 30 minutes before I pushed them out, they checked me. They said I was 7 centimeters. Y'all been feeling like the whole time that I had to push, you know what I'm saying? I had to poop, I had to do all the stuff. What?
I thought the whole video.
Why?
Because I don't think you got that first part at all.
I did. I just looked back. Mm-hmm. But I kept telling the lady, and I kept telling the lady. So, she was just like, no, don't push. Just hold on. Like, just being petty. So, but she thought.
You, see, obviously, even though you was firsthand, you know, you experienced all that stuff. I was right there next to you. I seen everything. Okay?
Y'all look at him ready to sneeze.
No, because you're not finna downplay the story. You're not gonna shortcut it. None of that. I got my hair nappy today. I don't care, because I need them to know this whole story. Okay. So, the first 2 to 3 centimeters was like a little smooth ride. We cruising all the way through. You know, even after they gave her that, what's that thing that they did to induce you?
Pitocin.
The Pitocin. They were telling me how monstrous this is to actually take the Pitocin. I was just like, I don't see it. She not doing anything different. Like, everything is just still going smooth. She hit 6 centimeters. And it was like hell opened up at one time.
You trying to play me.
No, because you going to downplay and you going to shortcut this story. They need to know exactly what happened. So, they gave her that. She got to her 6 centimeters, and she started acting crazy.
My contractions were every 2 to 4 minutes.
You're cutting me off, Wilson. She started with saying, Darius, why would you do that to me? And I'm just like, what you talking about? She started crying. So I'm just like, what the heck going on with her? She's just like, I want some strawberry park tarts.
That's when they gave me the IV medicine.
Everybody in the room was just like, what the heck going on with her? She mad about some strawberry park tarts. And we trying to get her to the promised land and get this baby out of her. So she cried for that for a minute. You know what I'm saying? Nobody took that too serious. But that was just only the beginning. That's how she opened it up. That's how she opened the whole show. So later on, at first she was very cooperative about everything that I did, everything I said to her. I'm calming her, I'm rubbing her feet. She got to the point, she threw that headband off. She told me, no! I ain't listening to nothing else. I tried to rub her feet. She kicked my hand off of her feet. I tried to rub her head. She's moving away from me. I'm like, I can't do nothing for her but let her squeeze my hand. And she dang near took my hand off. But they ain't have nothing on what she did to me when she got the 7 centimeters. She got the 7 centimeters, and I let her hold my hand. She eased her head up to my arm and bit me. And I thought this was going to be a little playful bite until I just started feeling them teeth digging. I'm just like, what's her real issue? Like, I almost knocked out, but I don't want to talk about that either.
I'm bugging. He played too much, y'all.
From there, she already showing out. We get her over to the little wheelchair. They said that maybe that'll ease the pain a little bit. It did absolutely nothing.
That was not a wheelchair. It was a rocking chair.
The rocking chair. I can't even remember because we beat me right before that. So she sat in a little rocking chair, the one just like the one I got. She sat in a little rocking chair. It lasted for all of 2 seconds. She went to sleep. And I was just like, it's over. Like, I thought we had to make it. Lola, the nurse, looked at me and said, well, she's asleep right now, but she's only going to be asleep for a second. She's at 7 centimeters. She's going to wake up in a minute, and she's going to probably be acting crazy again. She woke up and said, oh, my goodness, I'm about to push. So then she was like, you can't push. You're not at 10 centimeters. Your cervix is going to swell up if you do that. She said, I don't care. I'm already pushing. She was just like, you can't push. You can't push. She's like, okay, I'm not going to push. He's coming down anyway. So now we just like, we got to get her to the bed. We got to get her to the bed. They're trying to call the midwives to come up there. They started moving fast. At first, they was moving like slower than
slow. I told her 3 times and she kept telling me the same thing.
They had just checked her. She was at 7 centimeters. So they were just like, there's no reason to like check her again. She was just at 7 centimeters. Okay, Jay.
What you gonna get?
Now you can see me while I tell the last part. Y'all need to see me while I tell the last part. I'm willing to turn on every light in here for y'all to understand what I'm trying to say. This girl told the doctor she ain't finna hold nothing. They told her, well, look, like, wait till we get the midwife here. She said, he's already coming. She's already coming. And everybody in the room is yelling. I'm still calm. That's just not who I am to be yelling and acting crazy. But everybody in the room was acting crazy and yelling. Especially when he started to crown and she closed her legs. Because now she wants to cooperate and he's halfway out. Either way, the midwife just happened to be at the door. She opens up the door, flies in. Carter shoots out into her hand. And from there, it was like everybody got relaxed at one time. But it was like five nurses in there and one midwife. It was spectacular.
First of all, where all them people go from?
I don't know. They all, like, I didn't see anybody come into the room but the midwife.
Me
and the lady,
too.
And the two ladies that was already in there. That third lady that came in there, I have no idea where she came from. No idea. But, yeah, it was quite the show. So then her brother decided to bring over King, his older brother. And he had one look at that blood and that mess of a gray baby, and he was just like, no, sir. He didn't go nowhere near Carter after that. That's the end of my story right there. That's all I wanted to say. That's all I wanted to say.
I'm bugging.
Nah, because they need to know how bad you was and how you bit me and how you was kicking. You was fussing about Pop-Tarts. You saw me.
I told the lady 3 times, go in and call them midwife. Because you keep telling me not to push, and that's what I'm finna do. She said no.
You lied to her, though. You told her, I'm not even pushing, he just coming. You was pushing. I know you pushed.
Y'all, he was coming, and my reflex of my body was to push, though. And I told her that.
She's like, I'm already pushing.
Look, as soon as she turned around, I went ahead and pushed the baby out because she had me bent. And she was moving slow. Everybody in there was not moving fast. They was moving slow. Because they trying to wait on the midwife. And I told them, like, no, that ain't it.
She's like, if you can run up here, that would be great. And she's like, I'm already at the door. And the door opened up. And then I seen Carter head coming out. And she was right there to catch him at the end. Like, that's crazy. You gave them a nice little traumatic experience.
Did I?
Yeah. They're gonna definitely make sure when they discharge us, they're going to make sure they put on there that they don't need to come back.
But if she would have, baby, I told her 3 times.
Yes.
I asked this lady 3 times.
I think that she was just going with her intuition. She's like, they just checked you. Like, I'm going to check you for your peace of mind. But she didn't feel like she had to move fast because she just like, they just checked you. Like, literally.
Y'all, to be honest,
it wasn't even 30 minutes. The lady walked out 15 minutes before you went to 9.5 and was ready to shoot the baby out of her.
Y'all, to be honest, when I was sitting in that walking chair, I wasn't seeing nothing for real, but I was pushing. Because I felt him coming, like,
I thought I heard you go.
If y'all got, if you got a child already, you know what I mean. Like, either you're going to push or the baby is going to push himself out. So, Carter was going ahead. He was going ahead pushing, easing his little self out. So, I was helping him. Because that hurts. Like, that's the worst part of labor. When they start pushing themselves down. It's not actually pushing the baby out. It's the baby coming down. And it's just like, I did all this natural, so I felt everything. Like, I felt everything. So,
this is quite the experience.
I had so much freaking relief when he came out. Like, I still had a little bit of pressure because the placenta was still in me. But I had so much relief. Like, I feel like I changed bodies and everything.
Now, tell them all the things I was doing for you to keep you in the game the whole the whole labor.
Darius was massaging me. He was trying to calm me down, but y'all.
No matter.
If you're in a certain amount of pain, you know, when somebody is in labor, it's like fracturing all your bones at one time. So, y'all can just imagine what it feels like. Like,
I was brushing hair.
He was doing a lot, but I was irritated.
Vaseline. I was giving kisses. I was rubbing feet. Like, what else you wanted?
For that baby to come up out of me.
Leave me alone.
For that baby to come up out of me. And then, y'all, my mama. Let me tell y'all about my mama. My mama's sitting on a little couch thing. Minding her business the whole time. On the phone. On the laptop. Doing all this stuff. And I'm thinking in my head, she's so disrespectful. Like, she do not care about nobody.
She said, you finna drive her crazy this time.
And then my brother, he was being disrespectful too, because he had his headphones in. King was watching Paw Patrol, so
he wasn't trying to record nothing.
So Darius really was the only one trying to help me out, and that's why we didn't record the actual laboring.
They said we just came here for the baby.
The actual laboring process, because I was acting crazy when I got the seats. Like, I was trying to, the little bed thing right here, I was trying to pull it. I was trying to break it. Mm-hmm. I was just doing a lot of stuff.
I tried to take your hand off of there, and I started rubbing your arm, and that's when you bit me.
Yep.
Who did you think you are, the vampire?
I wanted you to feel some of the pain I was feeling.
You bit me hard.
Okay.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Darius always trying to be the calm person in the situation, but y'all know the calm person always get the most
abuse.
Yeah, the most abuse. Hey, you telling me to calm down, and I'm feeling all this pain, and I feel like, you know what I'm saying, you ain't feel it. Y'all know how people be like, I feel it. He ain't feel it. So I had to give him this work. I had to give him this word because he was playing. But after that, like, y'all see how
she fell right to sleep.
Yeah, y'all see how energized and stuff I look. All I needed was that baby out of me. That's all I needed.
They made me do skin to skin for a whole hour.
Yeah, he had to do skin to skin when I fell asleep because I was exhausted. And then I had that IV medicine in my system, so I was out. I don't even know how long I was out, but
we do got a few clips of the actual you holding him, the umbilical cord cutting and all that, so we should do some attachments in the video.
Yeah, I'm gonna attach the
a few clips.
Yeah, a few clips. I guess that's what y'all want to see for real anyways. But
she'll record you talking about them Park Tarts.
I was crying so hard, y'all. Let me tell y'all, I'm gonna tell y'all why I was really crying when Carter came out and they set him on me. Because, like, okay, the day before Darius had proposed to me, so I didn't cry when he proposed to me because it's just like I was in shock. It was just like it was a dream or something, but it really wasn't a dream, like real life. And then that night, my water had broke, of course. or early that next morning. Y'all, look at my hair. Don't mind it. But early that next morning, my water had broke. And I delivered King that afternoon. I said King Carter that afternoon. So it was just like everything hit me at once. Like, somebody engaged. Somebody proposed to me yesterday. I gave this same man his child the next day. So it was just like a lot going on.
I wish you would say it was even.
Huh?
I wish you would say it was even.
Even? About what? Because you didn't cry. Yeah, he didn't cry when my baby was delivered.
I cried on the inside.
But I didn't cry when he proposed.
But see, this what makes us not even though. Because you're an emotional person. You cried about some Park Tarts. Now, that's not unusual for you to cry about some food. You didn't cry about the proposal. How many times you seen me cry?
One time.
Don't tell nobody that. Oh God, I'll fight you.
But like, I'm gonna tell you why I didn't cry when he proposed to me, because we was going up. He proposed to me in church, so. We was doing offering and he grabbed me. He was just like, hold on. And I'm just like, if anybody know, I'm the type of person that if it's a lot of commotion going on, I'm trying to get out the way. And he was just like, hold on. And he didn't tell me the reason why. So I kept trying to walk off. And then the apostle told me to sit down. And I'm just looking at her like, what y'all got going on? And then I didn't know where Darius proposed to me, so I was in shock. Like, all I could think about was, this is really happening. But it's like a dream at the same time.
Why did it feel like a dream?
Because I ain't ever thought, like, I was going to get proposed to at 22. Not even just at 22, but, like, I ain't ever thought, like, nobody was going to marry me. Not because I'm a bad person or anything, but y'all know a lot of males that you deal with is kind of like the same person, but they're not the same person, if that makes sense. And it's like, I came to Georgia 2 years ago. Did I come to Georgia 2 years ago?
Yeah.
Came to Georgia 2 years ago. Me and Darius have been together a year and a half. And it's just like, ever since I met him, I knew he was going to marry me, but not this soon, if that makes sense. Because Darius only 23, too. And y'all know how.
I just look 30, so.
Y'all know how a lot of males just be like, they don't be thinking about that at an early age. It's just like, females do it, really. But Darius proposed to me. Like, I can't explain it. Like.
So you're saying that what made it special to you is the fact that you got proposed to when you was 22?
No, I'm saying what made it special is I moved to Georgia, okay? I moved to Georgia. I just left everything in North Carolina and I moved to Georgia. I met you how many months after I moved to Georgia? Like five months? Five or six months?
5 months. 5 to 6 months.
5 to 6 months after I moved to Georgia, and
it was 5 months,
yeah. Y'all know how, or y'all might not know, but when you meet the person that you're supposed to be with, it's just different how y'all meet. And it's just like me and Darius instantly clicked. Like, the first day we hung out, we was acting like we done known each other forever. And everybody know I'm scary, so I'm not the type of person that get in the car with somebody I don't know or hang with somebody I don't know by myself, if that makes sense. And I did it. You know what I'm saying? I did it. So I just think, you know what I'm saying? It's not a lot of males with a mature mind at a young age, and I feel like Darius is the most mature male that I've met, person that I met, period. Because, you know what I'm saying, he all about his family or whatever and making me happy. So, that's what made it a dream. Like, y'all know how you be like, my goal or my dream, the dream of my life. The dream of my life, I'm saying that right? It's like my dream happened. Like my fairy tale happened. That's what I'm looking for.
The dream of your life.
The dream of my life. My fairy tale happened. I met somebody that matched me. I met somebody that, you know what I'm saying, like have the same mindset as me. Everything about me, he just is about him. If that makes sense. It's like the person that I wrote on a piece of paper, the characteristics of the man that I wanted to marry. And Darius puts everything on that paper.
Go more into detail on the characteristics.
No, because I don't remember.
I'm sure. I just want to hear him.
He talking about I just want to hear him.
I
want
to know.
He already know because I showed him the paper.
Tell me.
I don't remember what I wrote on the paper for real.
Well, you know what you know what characteristics you like about a person.
Yeah. If I find it, then I'ma insert it in the proposal video. Because the proposal video going up first.
You're a very candid person, you know?
I will.
Very candid person. You're private, but you're being pretty open with your YouTubers.
Yeah.
So tell them what characteristics.
I'ma tell them in the proposal video.
Okay. That's probably better be good.
It is. But yeah, y'all. Today's June 5th. I don't know if I'm going to vlog for the rest of the day. This vlog 21 minutes already. But I need to, speaking of that, I need to do my proposal video. Because my proposal video going up first. And then the labor and delivery video going up next. Okay, y'all. There you stop.
Oh, sorry. That's what it is.
You can tell my people bye.
Bye.
Oh, we gonna see y'all later.
See you later.
So today we get out. Discharge. Y'all know I'm ready to go home. Like, I'm ready to get in my own bed, to be honest. But Carter's over there. Daddy is in the shower. I'm ready to go home and see Fat Fat. And I'm ready to, you know, see. You know what I'm saying? Like, see him bond with his brother. Like, I'm ready for us to bond as a family. I don't think I'm taking any phone call, text messages today because I'm not, like, exhausted, tired, but I'm just ready to bond with my family and we don't need to have no phones so we can get our little self together, okay? But, yeah. Hardy's over there sleeping. He had to get his circumcision. So, we're waiting for them to discharge us. They had to observe him for 2 hours. So, I think we got a good, probably 20 minutes left. I got my nose. A good 20 minutes left. And then we can go home. I'm ready for him to get home. Because we moved Friday still to the new house. And everything. But yeah, I'll talk to y'all later when we get outside, like on a ride home or whatever.
You need to take a bath then.
Okay, y'all, so we home. That's why you looking like that.
Hmm?
Why you looking like that?
Like what?
Like you looking. What is that?
What?
Is that a car?
Why didn't they see that mountain right there?
Fat Fat.
No, sir.
Fat Fat. Fat Fat. You happy your brother home? We're just chilling, letting Kenny play with the baby. My baby's so rough right now.
cares? I have to go to work. Right. I think I'm... Am I holding this phone?
But how can I explain myself? You said you care for me, baby.
Louisiana shit. Murder on the beat.